Hello, welcome. Thank you, Jack, Mel, for having us at the smallest pub in Britain. Again, not under dispute, the football match, match sorted all that out. Would you take them back on again?
Yeah.
Football, if, would you?
No, yeah. But rugby would be better.
Do you want to ring a role play for you?
Paintball would be far more entertaining.
I can play hockey quite well.
Against me.
Oh, she wears school uniform at the time. It's fine. Yeah, it's
all right, I'm in for that. I'm going to start straight on with this. For those of you that ended up here by mistake, sorry.
There's a door.
I'm come from Kunt. There's the door. There's 18 people in front of it, so you ain't going to be able to get out of it. I'm come from Kunt, the game. We'll be playing some songs from our collection of minor internet hits and a few tunes off my new album, Japs on my Tunes. This first one I'm going to start off with, I haven't played for over 18 months, so the chances, again, of me getting this spot on are very, very slim, but we're going to do it anyway. Now, this is a story, because I'm hoping, I played two sets here. The earlier one started off quite slowly, all right, so I'm trying to get the atmosphere going by playing my big party number right at the start. Now this is a song about my mate's party. This party happened over 20 years ago. Please bear in mind this party went so badly for him that he's still grounded even now. As a 37-year-old man with two kids and a full bush of pubes. This is called Paul Stevenson's Party. Now, I don't want to worry you, but it does start off with a little poem, all right? And at the end of that poem, on the album that it's from, Hurry Up and Suck Me Off Before I Get Famous. At the end of that poem, there's a lovely little delay effect on the album that takes you off into the track. It does sound rather lovely. I've been unable to recreate that live, so what I do in this place will sound a bit shit. The reason I'm telling you is I don't want you to think that I think it sounds really good, all right? So this is called Paul Stevenson's Party. The most raucous party ever wasn't after a premiere. It wasn't after the Oscars or BAFTAs, and there was no one famous there. It happened in 1994 in a Stifford Clay's cul-de-sac. I turned up there at 8:30 and the place was fucking packed. Now, there was no Facebook in those days, no Bebo or MySpace. Fuck knows how 200 people ended up in the same place. Two blokes are fighting out the front. It was actually quite frightening. So I'll just go in and make a start on 3 litres of white lightning. Lightning. That's what I was on about. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's bash. His house got fucking trashed by 200 people on the lash. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's do. It was the greatest party I ever went to. Someone's replacing a light bulb with a pack of jelly cubes. This bloke's got his mumsy Mac and he's waxing off his pubes. The kitchen seems to have been retiled with buttered Jacob's crackers. One kid's using a slotted spoon to whack another kid in the knackers. Someone's tipped a box of Kellogg's cornflakes on the floor. Someone else has got a screwdriver and he's taking off a door. There's a bloke pirouetting round the kitchen with a bottle of tomato sauce. This girl has just sucked six blokes off and he's crying with remorse. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's bash. His house got fucking trashed by 200 people on the lash. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's do. It was the greatest party I ever went to. This bloke is making pizzas with his mum and dad's CDs. So now the damned and squeeze, atop with ham and cheese. Three kids threw his mattress out the window onto the lawn. Now they're in his old man's bedroom, going through his stash of porn. Some bloke's fingering a sleeping girl up on the pile of coats. Someone filled the fish tank up with a box of Quaker Oats. There's one kid smashing ornaments with his dad's golf umbrella. Someone's written rape on the front room wall in what's hopefully Nutella. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's bash. His house got fucking trashed by 200 people who gave crash. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's do. It was the greatest party I ever went to. Has anyone seen Paul? Oh, there he is on the sofa. He's passed snout and someone shaved one of his eyebrows off. Now they're writing paedophile backwards on his forehead. Permanent marker. His parents will wish they hadn't stayed out for the night when they find the telephone handset's been glued on with araldite. There's blood where some girl got broken up on his parents' bed. This geezer's strolling round with his sister's panties on his head. Two young kids jimmied off the lock of his old man's drinks cabinet. I didn't see you did that in the sink, but it looks like human shit. The toilet's overflowing where someone laid a massive log. This girl's pulled on his rubber glove and he's wanking off a dog. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's bash. Some bloke stood on his shed roof, pulled his pants down and had a slash. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's do. It was the greatest party I ever went to. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's bash. Someone defaced a photo of his late man with a Hitler hair and tash. Paul Stevenson's party, Paul Stevenson's do. It was the greatest party I ever went to.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
This is a song that I'd like to dedicate to anyone who has ever left something unflushed. And this is called Bangers and Mash. I was in the pub and I needed a piss. I went to the toilet so I could do this for someone and stuffed some bog roll in the urinal and someone else had a piss there and it was awful. So I thought to myself, that's no problem at all, I'll just relieve myself in the cubicle. Luckily there was no one in there doing a shite, but when I opened the door I saw a terrible sight. For fuck's sake, I only wanted a slash, but the bloke before me left bangers and mash. Bangers and mash, bangers and mash, the bloke before me left bangers and mash. He could have flushed it away, but he didn't today. He thought I'll let someone else find me bangers and mash. I tried to block it from my mind, but I was unable. I wanted toilet paper and a freshly laid cable. It was fucking massive. It looked like Heather Mills' stump covered in fake tan. I gave it a flush, but it just wouldn't budge. The fog just filled up with water, toilet paper and fudge. There's a knock on the door, and I think in a flash, the next bloke's gonna think it's me that left the bangers and mash. Honestly, mate, I'll give you my word, that wasn't my bog roll, and that wasn't my turn. Bangers and mash, bangers and mash, the bloke before me left bangers and mash. He could have flushed it away, but he didn't today. Thought I'd let someone else enjoy me bangers and mash. Bangers and mash, bangers and mash, the bloke before me left bangers and mash. He could have flushed it away, but he didn't today. And now the next bloke thinks that I left the bangers and mash. Bangers and mash.
Thank you very much.
Darren, did you hear that song?
How was that? What's that?
It doesn't matter. The word's out.
Are you the phantom that everyone's been talking about?
Probably. Yes.
I think it's Birchie. Yeah, I think it's...
I don't mind you not flushing, but just try and eat less sweet corn. So this next one I'm going to do is you ladies here tonight, you might not know this, you might know it, you might not, but before us blokes leave the house, we've got a little mental checklist that goes keys, money, mobile phone, have I washed me cock in case I get sucked off later, and this song is all about the fourth one in that list. This is called Gentleman's Wash. You out on a date, but unfortunately I got home really late. I didn't have time for a bath or a shower. There's only one thing that could save us. It's just like a shower, but it's over the sink. The only thing that gets washed is shiny and pink. If there's a possibility of fellatio, you have to make sure that your knob doesn't smell like quavers. Quavers. A gentleman's wash. A gentleman's wash. If you think there's half a chance you might get a nosh. Pull back your skin, wash the helmet with it, and that's a little gentleman's wash. It's a prototype. The other weekend, I was out on the piss when this girl who is wankered came and gave me a kiss. She said, I bet you've got a big knob, cause you've got big hands, just like Peter Shilton. I come straight from footy and I thought me cock must stink, so I rushed to the box and flopped it out in the sink. Oh boy, if I'm gonna get sucked off, it's only good manners to make sure that me knob doesn't smell like Stilton. Stilton. A gentleman's wash. A gentleman's wash. If you think there's half a chance your cock might get a nosh. Pull back your skin, wash the helmet with it, pull your pants to one side, wash the member they hide, and that's a little gentleman's wash.
Thank you very much. You know, I may have mentioned or I may not, I have a new album out at the moment called Japs iTunes, and I don't normally get that political, but there's something I feel very strongly about. So I've written a song about it on the new album, and I'm going to play that for you now, and this is cool. That's why I'm voting UKIP.
Did you know in Jamaica, ladies have a cloaca, that means a bum and fanny all in one. Did you know in Paraguay, they stretch girls very pie, and insert a big ceramic cup. And did you know in Senegal, birds have got no quim at all, they cut their clip box off and sew it up. The thing I really fear is what if they come over here, all them foreign fannies in our own backyard. I'm gonna go in my garage with a picture of Nigel Farage and make myself a big purple placard. Cause that's why I'm voting UKIP. Don't think me unhinged. That's why I'm voting UKIP to save the British minge. That's why I'm voting UKIP. My message is succinct. Don't let the great British minge become extinct. Let the great British minge become extinct. God save our gracious minge. Long live our noble minge. Nigel, help us save the British minge. Send it victorious, hairy and glorious. Nigel, help us save the British minge. Did you know in Saudi Arabia, no one's seen a lady's labia, cause they have to do their business in the dark. And in Papua New Guinea, did you know a lady's mini has got a set of teeth just like a shark? And did you know that in Iraq, a lady's crack emits a bit of discharge like crude oil? And did you know in Bulgaria, ladies' panties are hairier than anywhere in the world except Susan Boyle? The main parties don't go far enough to protect the British muff. The only way to stop it is to vote. I considered the BNP, but they're too far right for me. They want to put Thatcher's fuck flaps on the back note. That's why I'm voting UKIP. Don't think me unhinged. That's why I'm voting UKIP to save the British minge. That's why I'm voting UKIP. Come on, join the hunt. You gotta love Nigel Farage, cause he's a proper British cunt.
Thank you very much.
Tell me you've actually sent him a version of that.
I believe he's aware of it.
Now he's had to ditch the UKIP Calypso. He's on about taking that on for the elections next year. This next one is another one off my album, Japs on iTunes. And for years and years, people have been saying to me, while I've been touring around the country playing my minor in net hits, people have been saying to me, "Cunt, you got to write a song about your crazy times on the road." And I finally got around to it. I'm going to play that song for you now, and this is called "The Lonely Wank in a Travel Lodge."
You know you're lonely when you take fucking life.
People think it's a glamorous life, touring with your songs. But after the gig, everyone goes home and the nights can seem so long. The pretty girls have all got boyfriends and they all go home to have it off. And I'm left alone in a chain hotel, trying to imagine them having it off. And it's then there's no way I can dodge a lonely wank in a travel lodge. 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 Lonely salesman who wanked it before me. They didn't want to pay 10 quid for Wi-Fi, so they just used their 3G. When I'm finished, I'll fill up the tiny little kettle and I'll make a cup of tea. The batteries are held in with electrical tape on the remote for the TV. Sometimes I do it in front of the mirror just to feel like there's someone else there. But all I see is my crying self wanking back at me in despair. The pretty girls have all gone home with all the handsome boys. I've just spent 2 quid in the vending machine on a bag of steak McCoys. And now some jizz from my nuts I'll dislodge via the medium of a lonely wank in a travel lodge. A lonely wank in a travel lodge. A lonely wank in a travel lodge. A lonely wank in a travel lodge.
Thank you very much. It's nice to speak at you in that way, Chris. So this,
we knew that.
Chris, will you wave to the camera? This is Antiques Chris.
Hello.
Antiques Chris has just sold me Jimmy Savile's original jumpsuit from the 70s. Just trying to finish his career off.
It was on the rocks.
So this one I'm going to do for you now. This is a sexy song. I'm warning you this because there's a lot of people packed into a tight space. So if anyone feels anything, nudging them in the back, that's going to be one of these men who, throughout the duration of this song, at some point will probably go from completely flaccid to almost half-mast. I'm just warning you. I can see doubt in faces thinking, no, you're not going to do that to me. But ladies also, I'm warning you.
It's
going to flash. I'm warning you. You might want to get a mop ready because it's a sexy song. It's fine, but ladies have told me in the past that this song has made them a little bit frothy in the fuck flap department. I'm just saying. Have you got a wet floor sign at all? I'm just saying. All right. All right, I'm going to play this song for you. This is a song called Wank Fantasy. Which I found quite nice. I've imagined you sucking me off in my car in the cold light of day. I suppose it won't go that far, cause you know what you are. You're just a wank fantasy. A wank fantasy. Something I thought of to arouse me. I'm sorry when you knocked. I was playing with my cock in the middle of a wank fantasy. In the middle of a wank fantasy. You're the mother of my best friend. You're still quite attractive, I'll give you 6 out of 10.
What if one day my mate is out when I knock, and while his daddy's at work, you end up sucking my cock? And I won't tell you to stop, because I like it a lot. It's just a wank fantasy, a wank fantasy. Something I thought of to arouse me. I'm sorry when you called, I was playing with my balls in the middle of a wank fantasy. In the middle of a wank fantasy. You're still quite slim. You're watching on me changing in the cubicles, but when I pulled down your pants, you had a cock and balls. It didn't matter at all. It's just a wank fantasy, a wank fantasy. Something I thought of accidentally. I'm sorry when you emailed, I was not sneaking a shemale in the middle of a wank fantasy. In the middle of a wank fantasy. In the middle of a wank fantasy.
Thank you very much. Yay. Thank you.
Oh, we've got a crowd.
Oh, tourists.
Proper tourists.
Hello, proper tourists. Proper tourists.
Rockles.
So this one I'm going to do now, this is about the former love of my life. It's a lady I spent over 20 years completely dedicated to, but it was an unrequited love, and she never once returned my phone calls, emails, texts, faxes, or little jiffy bags full of spunk that I sent into the Countdown Studios. This is called Carol Vorderman. Carol's really beautiful, but very good at sums. Willie in a noonie or a bum. She always gets the numbers right, she's got me into maths. I'll take away her pants and add my Corey to a gas. Shout Carol, when I see you on Countdown, I have to pull my pants down and pop a finger in my brow. When she multiplies, I unzip my flies. Then when she divides, I put my hand inside. And then when she adds, pop out my knob and nads. Then when she subtracts, I perform a sexual act. Carol's really glamorous, she wears the latest stuff. She's fit for 40 something and I want to doink her muff. She tells you the target, but it is my goal to one day divide her flaps and then square root a hole. Oh Carol, when I see you on Countdown, I have to put my pants down and pop a finger in my brow. Oh Carol, when I see you on Countdown, I have to pull my pants down and pop a finger in my brow. I've loved Carol Vorderman since 1985. I sometimes like to lurk around the bottom of her drive. I sometimes like to follow her when she goes to the shops. I sometimes open up her drains and examine her plops. I met her once and told her that I was her biggest fan. She sent me an autograph and put it in my hand. But at that point I felt a little throbbing in my gland. I realised I was ejaculating in my pants over Carol Vorderman. Carol Vorderman. Carol, Carol, Carol Vorderman. Carol Vorderman.
Thank you very much. Hang on, please, you enjoy that one, because this next one is fundamentally exactly the same idea, so done slightly differently.
It's not Rachel Riley, is it?
Oh! You recognise it from the description. Now, obviously, after Carol left Countdown, I was bereft. I was inconsolable. And then they put a new bird on the Countdown. Now, some of you will know Rachel Riley off of Countdown. Mm-hmm. Some of you will know Rachel Riley off of 8 out of 10 Cats does Countdown.
Yeah, it's a butcher's dog.
Some of you will know Rachel Riley from Strictly Come Dancing. Some of you know Rachel Riley from the news story last year that she broke up with her husband.
Yeah.
Oh. Never mind. She goes clubbing down the road with me in Southend. I know where she goes, so I'm going to turn up there, I'm going to play my song of love that I'm about to play you. And if that don't work, there's always drink sprinkles. So this is my song of love to Rachel Riley, and this is called Rachel Riley. When Carol left, Kunt, me was upset. Me never thought me was gonna get over it. But time's a great healer, and me must admit, me found another girl with whom I'd like to get me not sweat. Her name is Rachel, and she's from Southend. Me got a little message that me like to send. Me like to wine and dine you and be your boyfriend. Then get you in me car and make you suck me belly. Rachel Riley, you make me smiley, so me sing you a song in a rub-a-dub style. Rachel Riley, you make me smiley, so me write this song for you. Rachel Riley, you make me smile. Me put me finger in me brown, but me got a small pile. Rachel Riley, you make me smile. So me write this song for you. Ba-ra-ba-bum-bum. It's a bit long this bit. I hope you get me breath back. Cause they cut her pay. She still has pride of Britain, though me have to say. Me went to have a wank, but to my dismay, there's so many disabled kids me just could not spray. When me see you on countdown, me have to pull me pants down. I pop a finger in me bro. Missing you on the TV with Jeff Stelling. I cough down the show about words and spelling. Suddenly me feel me trousers swelling. A bit of white wee wee me was expelling. Rachel me think me's becoming a fanatic. Cause every time me see you me feel ecstatic. Me get a box of tissues and go up the attic. You know what me's up to? You do the mathematic. Rachel Riley, you make me smiley, so me sing you a song in a rub-a-dub style. Rachel Riley, you make me smiley, so me write this song for you. Ba-ra-ba-bum-bum. Rachel Riley, you make me smiley, put me finger in me brown, but me got a small pile. Rachel Riley, you make me smiley, so me write this song for you. Ba-ra-ba-bum-bum. Oh, Rachel. When me see you on countdown, me have to pull me panties down and pop a finger in me brown. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Ned. Those songs about Rachel Riley and Carol Vorderman. Rachel and Carol, they obviously got something in common apart from being on countdown. Is neither of them have ever had it off with me. And
yeah.
The only reason I can, I live in Melbourne, but it ain't gonna fucking happen.
I've known for my
lot. The only reason I can assume behind that is that I'm not enough of a bastard. And an example I'd like to give you of women loving a bastard is Catherine Zeta-Jones, the lovely Catherine Zeta-Jones. Some of you men who've just come in here, you sir, at the back there, you'll remember Catherine Zeta-Jones, weren't you? Lovely Catherine Zeta-Jones from the 90s when she was in her prime, lovely.
Yep.
Yeah, and some of you younger men, the man who was here a minute ago, who's gone for a poo. He won't.
I'll see Mike.
Yeah. He won't. Well, someone needs to go for a poo, just to kind of smell is drifting forward. You won't remember Catherine Zeta-Jones, but Catherine Zeta-Jones in the 90s, she was really lovely. So if you don't remember Catherine Zeta-Jones, just go onto Google, put in Catherine Zeta-Jones, and up will pop some images of Catherine Zeta-Jones looking really lovely. Now, Catherine Zeta-Jones, she always loved a bastard. And I know this because she went out with John Leslie for a while. Rapey bastard. Rapey bastard. And then she got married to Michael Douglas. She was married to him for 20-odd years. Michael Douglas last year got throat cancer. Do you know what he blamed it on? He blamed it on his addiction to cunnilingus. That's licking birds out on that. He's been married to Catherine Zeta-Jones for 20 years, so he's saying that's a bastard. Well, but mind you, if I'd have got together with Catherine Zeta-Jones in the mid-90s, I'd have spent the last 20 years licking around. So maybe I had a lucky escape from her carcinogenic fanny batter. I don't mean that, I'm just trying to be more of a bastard to introduce this next song. And this is called Women Love a Bastard. Look at you, pretending there's some steps there. That's your Michael Barrymore trick. When I was a young boy, this kid Neil, he pulled the wings off of daddy long legs and little flying things. The girls all flocked around him just to see the skill he'd mastered. When I asked him why girls liked him, he said, "Women love a bastard." So when I grew up, I must admit that once or twice I went out with girlfriends and I tried to treat them nice. Every time I did that, it just ended in disaster. Then I remembered Neil's advice that women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. I quickened up my pelvic thrust so I can climax faster. Then I have a fag and fall asleep, cause women love a bastard. So when I met my current bird, I had to hatch a plan to attempt to be a bigger bastard of a man. She cooked a meal for Valentine's, I tried to play it cool. I took one mouthful, spat it out and threw it up the wall. When she posted Facebook status, I never once clicked like. On that cycle ride for charity, I pushed her off her bike. I left her in the hospital with a leg in plaster while I went round and fucked her mum, cause women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. She broke down in church and ended up asking the pastor why I did it. He replied, cause women love a bastard. I bought her a 99 from the ice cream place. Then when she went to take a lick, I smashed it in her face. She's got a nan with Alzheimer's who's not allowed out. I left her in her underwear on Bentley roundabout. Then when she did that fun run to raise money for the hospice, I went round, got a toothbrush and I stuck it in some dog's mess. I rinsed it off with water and before she went to bed, as she brushed her teeth, I texted her and this is what it said. Dog shit, dog shit, you brushed your teeth with dog shit. Dog shit, dog shit, you brushed your teeth with dog shit. I never come straight home from work, I stay out and get plastered. I do it just to turn her on, cause women love a bastard. I super glued her eyes open and I must concede I made her watch the sequel to The Human Centipede. I took her away from all her friends and got her hooked on crack. Then I forced her to go on the game so she could pay me back. But it all backfired on me and she walked out today to go live in a refuge where abused women stay. So now I sit outside her window with a ghetto blaster and placed it not till 4 a.m. cause women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. If you ask me why I did it, oh, you're fooling me. I was only trying to make a moist, cause women love a bastard. I was only trying to make a moist, cause women love a bastard.
Thank you very much.
Silly old bastard.
Right.
He's come back.
I'm going to introduce her. Friend of mine at the stage now.
Mr. Hey. Hey. Hey.
Those you haven't met before, this is Little Cunt now.
Little.
He's his disgusting up front. He's done over 500 gigs. You want to smell him?
Oh.
Now listen.
That'll laugh.
Little Cunt, Child's Play 3. So this one I'm going to do now, this is fundamentally a lovely love song, but it's about serial killers, and this is called Fred and Rose.
Oh.
What, too soon?
We young ladies,
I like it when they're old.
You like pussies that are really hairy,
and you like it when they're bold.
I like comedy that is really subtle,
I like slapstick and fast.
You like to have straight sex with a lady,
and you like it when you're up your ass.
No, I don't. Sure, we've got lots of differences, but when it comes down to it, the bottom line is that heaven knows
There's nothing that I wouldn't do.
We like bread and rose.
I'd murder the lodger for you. And while you're entertaining a string of Caribbean gentlemen,
you'll be downstairs in the cellar, digging out a massive hole.
And while I'm raping, murdering and burying a hitchhiker,
I'll be upstairs in my negligee, sliding up and down a black man's pole.
It's not PC, but it is factually accurate.
I like to look at a traditional wank mag,
and I like internet grog.
I like DVDs with girl on girl action,
and I like to see a pop shop.
You think your cock looks best with a hard on,
you're happy with yours on the soft.
You like getting your penis fellated
while you watch and wank yourself off.
Fucking dope.
Sure, we've got lots of differences, but when it comes down to it, the bottom line is that
heaven knows there's nothing that I wouldn't do.
We like bread and rose.
I'd murder the lodger for you.
And heaven knows there's nowhere that I'd rather be.
You've met the lodger for me.
Thank you very much.
Now, some of you will know this already, and some of you won't know this, but in recent years, I had to assume another role, and that is the role of conduit to dead celebrities who feel like they've got a score to settle. It's a dirty job, but someone's got to do it. I was visited in the middle of the night by a much maligned celebrity ghost. If anyone knows who I'm talking about, please don't say, because I don't want to spoil it for the people that don't know. But this much maligned celebrity ghost said to me, now then, cunt. He said, could you please write a song that explains my side of the story? And obviously, I didn't want to fucking do that. And then he said, you could put it to a really catchy tune, so even when people don't like it, they'll still wake up singing it the following day. So that's what I've done. This is an horrible song. It's only 2 minutes long, though. We can all get through it together. I suddenly awoke to the spectral shape of this ghostly bloke. He was floating above me, just there in midair. He had a shell suit on and a mop of blonde hair. He said,
"Don't it, Sir Jimmy, return to attempt with your help my reputation to save."
He said,
Now then, can you write me a song to explain what's happened with those girls and my tongue?"
I said, "I'm not sure. I'd have to hear that explanation in case people think I'm a pedo by association." And this is what he told me. It was,
sexy kids, made Jimmy Savile do what he did.
Those kids weren't content in his sheltered bottom to tent in with his feelings for the sexy kids.
Now then, what about that then?
So Jimmy's ghost continued to maintain he'd done nothing wrong, and he tried to explain he had a cigar on his lips, and by that I don't mean that he was desperate to use the latrine. He said,
"All my good work will now be forgot because of my bomb chump for underage what?"
He said,
"Surely those marathons and charity races offset my spunking on teenagers' faces."
I said, "I'd write the song to get rid of his ghost," but then he told me one more time what bothered him most. It was,
sexy kids, made Jimmy Savile do what he did.
He got them in his rolls, offended their holes, then gave charity a load of quits.
Jimmy Savile and the sexy kids.
Marvellous, marvellous, just don't tell your mother.
Thank you very much.
What's
it for?
No.
Thank you, see you later. What Jimmy would have wanted.
just don't.
Oh dear.
Yeah, just don't.
Now
that you can't edit out,
that's
it.
This next one, I think we should just fucking finish it there. Really.
Yeah, it's probably a good idea.
Thank you very much. Good enough. This next one I'm going to do, this is my greatest minor internet hit out of all of them. I know some of you know what to do, but for the people that ain't seen this before, I'm going to explain what I do in this next song. This next song is my greatest minor internet hit, and I think this is because people know this is a song that means most to me. This dates back to a date in the early 80s when I was a little boy. And my granddad said to me, "Cunt." He said, "Come and sit with me next. I want to teach you a word to use through life when something small goes wrong." And I said, "What's that word, Grandad?" And he said, "It's the word fucksticks." Right, so what I'm going to do here tonight in this increasingly sweaty, smallest pub in Britain. Not a bit close, isn't it? Fuck's sake. I would like to give you a bit of fucksticks and you all give me a bit of fucksticks back, all right? Are we in?
Yeah.
Right, let's give it a go. Fucksticks!
Fucksticks!
Right. You weren't fucking doing
six?
It.
I've got it. Hey, I've got my own fuck sticks, mate.
Well, can you pull them out or turn the batteries off for a minute? So this one. So this...
Hold on. Yep, got you.
Thank you. Right, let's give it another go. Right, this is in memory of me granddad, remember, because he's not with us anymore.
Oh.
He's not dead, he just moved out to live with some slag. I want to give you a bit of fuck sticks and you all give me a bit of fuck sticks back. Let's give it another go. Fuck sticks!
Fuck sticks!
Right, that's the kind of level of commitment I'm after. Right, there it is. You've got to get black boys.
Did you see that?
I missed it.
There's another phrase I want to teach you, right, for when something slightly worse than a fuckstick's moment happens. This goes back to that day in the early 80s. My granddad picked me up. He put me on his knee again because I've gone to run off, and he's given me a Werb's Original to retain my attention. Now, for those of you that don't know, Werb's Originals are sweets kept in the pockets of paedophiles. Right, but this was the early 80s. It was a much more innocent time. The pedos hadn't got the addictive qualities for kids yet, so it was an innocent gesture. At this point in the early 80s, no one had ever referred to a Werber's as a nonce nugget. Right? My granddad said to me on that day, he said, "This phrase I want to teach you for when something slightly worse than a fucksticks moment happens." And I said, "What's the phrase, Grand? What's the phrase?" And he said, "It's the phrase, mother's cunt." Right, so what I'd like to do here, in the fucking nutshell, I would like to give you some fucksticks, and you all, in memory of my granddad, on Remembrance Day, don't quite feel right doing it. Let's soldier on through that, that's what they're doing. I'd like to give you a bit of fucksticks, you all give me a bit of mother's cunt back. Let's give it a go. Fucksticks!
Mother's cunt!
Right, that was perfectly adequate. No need to do that again. Apart from for fun. Fucksticks!
Mother's cunt!
I'll tell you what, you put some fucking venues with 200 people in the show. So, alright, well, those phrases, the fucksticks and the mother's cunt, I'd like you to use them all the way through this next song, alright, all the way to the end. It's 2 minutes 28 seconds, you just have to carry on right the way through to the end, alright, with the fucksticks and the mother's cunt, alright. Please bear in mind, you've only got to do it for 2 minutes 28 seconds. I've had to play this song 1,701 times. Thank you, and this is called Fucksticks. This is my greatest minor internet hit out of all of them. If I was Chico, this would be It's Chico Time. Now my old granddad had a word he used when things went wrong. To introduce this word to you, I'll put it in a song. So every time this word gets used, his memory lives on. I'm about to tell you what it is, so you can sing along.
Foxes!
When them wouldn't let him touch a furry pie.
Foxes!
And he got some shrapnel lodged in his chap's eye.
Foxes!
When a German sniper shot him in the cock.
Foxes!
When he found a lump on his left bollock.
Foxes!
When me nan died and she left him all alone.
Foxes!
When he let a bogus caller in his home.
Foxes!
When the first black people moved into his street.
Foxes!
When arthritis meant he couldn't beat his mate.
Fucksticks! Mother's cunt!
Fucksticks! Right, I'm impressed with that level of commitment. That's why I'm doing my little cockney knees up and I'll do all on my own. Just like Chaz would at Dave's funeral. He gets double the royalties now, doesn't he?
Fucksticks!
sticks, mother's cunts,
fuck sticks.
Now every time I hear the word, I start to reminisce. I'll suddenly taste Werther's and get a faint whiff of piss. So when someone annoys me or things get on my pit, I'll think of the moaning racist old cunt and really let it rip.
Fuck
when I miss an open goal in five a side.
Fuck
when I lost my hard-ons after Nana died.
Fuck
when the teachers told me that I was no good.
Fuck
when the old Bill caught me wanking in the wood.
Fuck
when I'm having it off and I think of my old man.
Fuck
when little cuntly skid marks down the pan.
Fuck
when some motherfucker pushes in a queue.
Fuck
when you get caught short and really need a poo.
Fuck
when I came a tumbling off my BMX. When I split my frenulum while having sex.
Fastest.
When some smart ass bastard gives me my comeuppance.
Fastest.
When it's ages since I've seen a lady's tuppence.
Fastest.
When there's no clean pants, you have to wear your mums.
Fastest.
When your bird won't let you fuck her up the bum.
Fastest.
When you're feeling awkward and you don't know what to say. If you say fastest,
fastest, fastest, fastest,
that makes everything okay.
Fastest, mother's cunt.
Fastest. Thank you very much. Sterling work. Sterling work. So this next. So I want to eventually pack this in and just spend all day sat at a desk with people giving me bits of paper for me to draw spunky little cocks and bollocks on. That's the dream. That's the dream. Got the dream, ain't you? Well, it's come to the end of the set. I've got one more song for you, and this is a song all about losing a bet on a building site. With disastrous consequences. This was never the way I planned. Not my intention. I was labouring on a building site, doing an extension. It's not what I'm used to. I just needed the cash in hand. I lost a bet with Dave the bricklayer. And as a forfeit, I had to suck his gland. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. The taste of his cheesy dipstick. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. I knew I should have took that job at quick fit. It felt so wrong, though it seemed strange yet. When everyone stood in a circle and clapped, I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. I didn't like it. And so the next day back on site, lots of banter followed. How was I supposed to know? I didn't have to swallow. It's not what proper blokes do. Not how they should behave. I can't show my face down the pub. Since I noshed off that bricky Dave, I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. The feel of his veiny fuck stick. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. Cause someone Facebooked a photo of it. It felt so whack, it took so long. To think that I was doing it wrong. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. I didn't like it. Us blokes, we don't do things by half. And on site, they like to have a laugh. And sometimes someone gets sucked off. And someone films it on their mobile phone. Ain't no big deal, but don't show his wife. She's bound to take it out of context. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. It didn't help me and I washed his helmet. I sucked off a bloke, can't deny it. It tasted like a bag of what's-its. It felt so wrong, it tasted so rank. I wish that I'd just give him a whack. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it. I didn't like it. Thank you very much.
Ian Walken.